Short barrels, 357 Magnum versus 40 Smith & Wesson. And what we have today is our Hornady Critical Defense ammunition. Interesting about this ammunition is that Critical Defense originally was designed for short-barreled handguns so you could get hollow point expansion. So they used that little plug in there to prevent, you know, clogging of hollow points. As we're more powerful ammunition, like normal 357 Magnum, I shouldn't say more powerful, but more traditional setups like a 4-inch barrel and a semi-auto or a revolver, you know, you really don't need that because there's so much velocity, it still expands regardless. But in Critical Defense, they designed it for short barrels by putting that plug in there. But interesting about this ammunition, even though it's designed for short barrels, I got some really good power in this when I tested it in longer barrels. My 357 Magnum, I tested it through a 4-inch barrel, and I got 1427 feet per second, which is 565 foot-pounds energy. Our 40 Smith & Wesson, I tested that through a 5-inch barrel, had 1200 feet per second, 527 foot-pounds energy. So very similar energies and comparable barrel lengths. So that's why I'm bringing these out, because I'm looking for something that's going to kind of rival a 357 mag snub nose, because currently it really is pretty much the most powerful pocket gun you can go with. So the reason why I'm using these, and this is a Taurus G2C and 40 Smith & Wesson, this is a Taurus 605 and 357 mag, is because the overall size and weight of these guns is the same. They both weigh about the same on my scale. You got about the same amount of barrel travel in those. So a 357 Magnum is actually rated at 1500 feet per second, and our 40 Smith & Wesson doesn't appear to say on the front of that, but it's one of these weird boxes where it says on the bottom 1175 feet per second. So we're gonna see what we get in short barrel. So I'm gonna go through the chronograph, see what kind of velocity and accuracy I can get at the same time. Then I'm gonna hit my 10% clear ballistic pack here. I'm just gonna go into plain clear ballistics to see what the best potential is of those cartridges are. And then after that, I'm gonna put on 4 layers of denim on the first 3-inch piece here that represents our pectoral muscle. After that, I'll have a 1/4-inch medium density fiberboard to represent hitting ribs or sternum. That'll be more of our real world simulation. And then I am going to shoot at my steel to see what kind of practical accuracy I can get with these. So let's get started with this test. All right, I'm about 5 yards from the target. You know, I got 1,200 feet per second with this particular Critical Defense 40 and the 5-inch barrel. Let's see what I get through this. This, by the way, is a 3.2-inch barrel. So if I can chamber around, I've had some issues with this since I picked it up. All right, let's see how close I get to that 1,200 feet per second. 1139. 1117, I'm having some issues here. 1131. Let me load up the rest of those and I'll keep trying to get some more numbers. And if I can make a request, please don't make this entire ballistic test video about this. I just picked this up yesterday with this ammo, and you know, I didn't anticipate getting a lemon from Taurus, so we'll keep going. 1130. I don't think that was a read, and the magazine keeps falling out, so let me go on to our 357 Magnum. All right, 357 Magnum here. I was getting 1427 feet per second average through our 4-inch barrel. Let's see how I get my 2-inch. Let me go single action on this first shot. See what kind of felt recoil I feel with this. 1240. 1295. Read. 1227. 1281. And honestly, the recoil for that isn't that bad. Case ejection is good. So, you know, even though it's kind of a full power load, it feels pretty good in the hand actually, which is interesting. So let's our ballistics gel block, see how these compare. All right, 40 Smith & Wesson, just plain gel. Here's our best potential here. See what we get with this. 357 Magnum. Let's go take a look. All right, so there's a little bit of difference there, but they both look pretty good. They both look like they're putting a lot of damage in that. And you know, the 40 went further, but it is a 165 grain. I don't think I even mentioned that before, and our 357 is a 125 grain. So you got a little bit more momentum there with our 40 Smith & Wesson. Good amount of damage. We went to about 15 inches, And with our 357 Magnum, we went to about 12 3/4. Sometimes camera parallax makes that look like I'm not lighting my finger up there exactly where it is, but I am. So what I'm seeing here with the 357 Mag, that's a very typical full powered performance where you're dumping a lot of energy quick. And our 40 Smith & Wesson also is doing just about as well. So let's put on our denim, put on our MDF, see how they compare that way. All right, four layers of denim, 1/4 inch MDF. This is more of our real world simulation. And I'm gonna keep my finger, my thumb away from that mag release 100%. And let's see what we get with this. All right, that whole thing moved. So let me put that back up and we'll hit it with the 357 mag. All right, 357 mag, now do more of our real world simulation. Let's go take a look. All right, so there's actually quite a big difference there between those. Very interesting here. Our energy dump in the first 3 inches looks pretty similar here. Through our MDF, you know, 40, 357. And honestly, what it looks like here when I see that, it almost looks like we're busting off pieces of that 357 because it's moving so fast. But our total damage path with our 40 Smith & Wesson went to about 18.5 inches. That plug's sitting out there, good expansion. Our 357 Magnum, though, has way more damage right there. You know, I would say that's from tumbling, but I can tell from these, you know, there's like lines in it, in the path that indicates that's actually ripping through that with an expanded hollow point or something like that. Either that or the MDF is actually truly ripping through a massive amount of damage. And we went to identical penetration. We're at like 18.5 inches, even though that 40 Smith & Wesson sucked back, it's the same penetration. So I would say in some regard, a short barreled 40 is pretty comparable to a snub nose 357. So that looks really good. So let's take a close up look at these and I'll hit the steel, see what kind of practical accuracy I can get with these. All right, so here's a look at these bullets up close. We have our 40 Smith & Wesson going through our plain gel. That looks very, very good. That's pretty textbook. That's looking really great for that. With our 357 Magnum, we have pretty much just as much expansion. Might be overall smaller because it started smaller, but that looks really good. Now going through our medium density fiberboard, our 40 Smith & Wesson still looks good. That's typically what we see with a little bit less expansion. You know, hitting the MDF kind of pushes it down a little bit, kind of the way maybe ribs or sternum would. But our 357 Magnum, it's interesting. It didn't over-penetrate and it did a massive amount of damage, but hitting that MDF, it kind of curved one side here and probably busted off some petals and just really reformed it a little bit. But the end result looks like very good performance. So if we have to take a look just at the bullets here, our 40 Smith & Wesson actually looks a little bit better here, overall performance, than our 357 Magnum. However, our 357 Magnum, you can't just judge the performance based on looking at something that's not perfectly flowered. That did way more damage through the MDF than what the 40 did. So overall though, very good performance with these. So that's a close-up look at those bullets. All right, because I obviously have some issues with that 40 Smith & Wesson pistol, I don't wanna like make it seem like the caliber is bad because I can't make as many shots rapid fire as possible. So rather than do kind of rapid fire stuff, I'm just gonna go for accuracy with each one of these rounds and just kind of see what kind of accuracy I can get with these. So I just decided to come back to 25 yards from the target. So 40 Smith & Wesson, let's see how where I can place these. Interesting. Well, I'm not sure whether to keep going with this or not. Yeah, I got that to go. Let me keep my hand real far away from that mag release. And we're having an issue here with this trigger's pinching where it won't move forward, and then it pinches, and then it goes to where it hits that wall. So interesting how that's designed and how that just falls out like that. That's not good. All right, 357 Magnum. Let's see if I can get with this. All right, I pulled one of those, but that hits really hard. So this is fun, so I'm gonna back up some more. Try to see some more rounds before I obviously gotta send that gun back in to where I got it. So let me back up a little bit. All right, 40 yards from the target for fun. I like to kind of see what kind of momentum we get here with these rounds. So 40 Smith & Wesson. Apparently that chambered. Just so used to it not chambering. So this is not a usable pistol. All right, 357 mag from 40 yards, snub nose. See if I can make any hits with this. That is so weird. I'm lining up those sights just right. That is weird. I normally don't have an issue from this distance with 357 mag out of a snub nose. You know, I'm not feeling a ton of recoil, not flinching, so I don't know why I'm missing. So we keep going. Weird. All right, I think I have a few more rounds of 40 Smith & Wesson here in my pocket. Hesitant to shoot these, but it's fun. This is, it hits a wall and it sticks. So it causes me to pull a shot. See that? I'm kind of exaggerating that, but what's happening is, I got this in a safe direction. And once it clicks, it stops, and you have to yank it really hard to get it to go back the rest of the way. I've never seen a pistol so bad right off the bat. This is worse than my Glock conversion. So, I'm done with this pistol here. It can go back to Taurus Muddy. But what we're seeing here for ballistic performance, you know, I believe it's a Glock 27 that's the 40 caliber. It's almost the same barrel travel, barrel length, and all that. So, take this information for kind of like the ballistic performance you're going to get with something like that. Looked pretty good with the critical defense. Both the 40 and the 357 mag, even though they're critical defense, and that generally means lower powered, these are actually very high powered cartridges, and they still continue to work really well in our shorter barrels. So I would say both are pretty equal here. 40 caliber though, maybe even in a good pistol, there might be some reliability issues with some ammo. That's not something I really have to think about with 357 mag. So that's what you get today. So as always, comment, share, and like, and thanks for watching.